changes. In 1776, this great nation accepted that armed conflict was the only way to preserve our rights to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. If our founding fathers could only see us now. From Antietam to Amiens, Okinawa to Anchorage,
we have fought. And now, the Red Menace is at our doorstep. Democracy itself is under threat of annihilation. That is why today, July 4th, 2076, 300 years after our great nation began, we gather together to honor the completion of Vault 76. This sprawling underground shelter may have been engineered by Vault Tech, but it was built by you, the good people of America, so that if the bombs do come, if the end does come, our way of life will endure. But not everyone will be saved. Those chosen to enter this vault must be our best and our brightest. For when the fighting is stopped and the fallout has settled, you must rebuild. Not just walls, not just buildings, but hearts and minds, and ultimately, America itself. So as we stand here today, we pray that the world will know peace. But if that is not our destiny, if war must come, we stand together knowing that here in Vault 76, our future begins.
Who may have overindulged and overslept. But it's time to get up and get out there. We've been locked away long enough. Today is Reclamation Day. It may be time to leave, but I'll never forget the day you all entered Vault 76. You come from every walk of life, every race, color, and creed. But you all share one very important trait. You are this country's best and brightest. But more importantly, you'll always be my family. have been tasked with nothing less than the rebuilding of America. Such a huge responsibility. Just know that Vault-Tec is proud of you. I am proud of you. When you hear this, it means I've been gone for several hours.
Sir, hello. Oh, my own finally! I've
out there in Appalachia.
Don't you remember?
This is the Overseer, signing off.
That's right, sir. Free samples. Yum, yum. Remember, sir. Rad-X to prevent radiation sickness. Rad-Away to cure it. Oh, come on. Building a personal power grid and making your own. Of a party last night, eh, sir? Good to see you all together one last time. Drunk, joyous, and not staving off a horrible death minute by minute. The cap is instrumental to the rebuilding of America. One tetanus amusing rusty shack at a time. Never stop learning. Be the best that you can be. Remember one of Vault-Tec's many, many mottos. Hard work is happy work. Over.
I knew this wasn't going to be the Appalachia I remembered, but... mutated animals? Haywire bots? No people so far. We have to be ready to rebuild. What I can confirm is... hostile territory. Fortunately, Vault-Tec was prepared. You see this? The cooking station? The stash box, the workbenches, all built with the camp. You need a home base out there. The construction and assembly mobile platform is designed to give you one. Just add resources, planning, and a little elbow grease. When you move your camp, everything you built is stored, ready to be placed back down in the new area. Use this to establish a foothold whenever you're in unfamiliar territory. I've left my camp behind so you can use it. I know I'm breaking my own advice by not taking it with me. But after seeing Appalachia for myself, I need to make sure every resident of 76 has a safe haven they can start from. I'll make do without it. If it's still standing, the town of Flatwoods is further down this road. Find me there. This is the Overseer. Signing off. Lodge, town of Flatwoods. My God. There's no one here. The old tavern, the church, people were using them for shelter, but...
With smart and a
mutations we expected. But there's something else. A disease. I was attacked by... Well, it used to be a person. But it had these green, glowing lesions, and its voice... angry.
Hey, volunteer. If you need supplies, Bob's got you covered.
Before they were wiped out, the survivors called themselves the responders. Police,
while
emergency
you're
medical staff.
Here, why not grab a stem pack or two?
Treating water, food, survival. I'm doing their tests, and you should too. I know it's even worse than we imagined, but someone's got to know where the missile silos are and how to secure them. The responders are the best lead we have. This is the Overseer, signing off.
Our stories for posterity, you know. It seems like a fine idea. So, hi, I am Kesha McDermott. When the bombs fell, I was in Watoka, coordinating a statewide science fair for that year's high school kids. And the theme was the future of energy. After the bombs, everything was pretty chaotic. Scavenging for food and fighting off rabid survivors. Oh, it was just a bad time all around. I found a couple of surviving kids from the high school whose parents didn't make it. And we holed up in a house in town for a while. After a bit, I was able to solder the circuitry in an old radio, and we tuned in to a broadcast from the responders. Oh, we were overjoyed. The trip from Watoka to Flatwoods, it was rough, mind you. The kids and I ran into a group of assholes in the mountains who stole our food and water. I can't tell you how happy I was to find the responders in Flatwoods. Tents for everyone. Open kitchens, medical supplies, protection. We were safe. They had a problem, though. Their water sources were contaminated heavily. People were boiling water, but not long enough to make it safe. So, I stepped up and I said, I'll build a testing kit to monitor the contamination, and I will teach folks how to properly boil water. And I did. The world is getting better, but slowly. We need to make sure it doesn't relapse, too. It's going to take time and care, that's all. Well, time, care, and science.
If you need supplies, Bob's got you covered.